I'm starting my own charity, right? I am, because at Christmas I went visiting me nan in, she's an old people's home, I went visiting me nan, and these people in the church came round, the old people's home, you know, singing carols, right? Singing carols to the old people. And then I just looked at them and think, you bunch of hypocritical bastards. Coming around, you know, attractive young girls coming around with their little Christian tits under a chocolate sweater, singing carols for old people. Old people don't want carols, do they? What do old people want? What do old people really want?
Prunes.
Apart from that, what do old people want? What did you say, sir? Sex! That's right! Sex! That's what old people want. They want sex. They're not sex, but that's what they want. That's why tonight, my own charity, right? Eddie Who's Fuck the Aged, right? Tonight here. Fuck the Aged tonight. Sean, tell you to volunteer, right? Half an hour a week to gobble off a war here, right? You, come on, Sean, tell me. Yeah, exactly. Don't you want to bloody listen to bollocks? Suck them off. I do want to listen.
You just
don't want to
like, when a woman really is just with 80 years of age.
She was sitting
over a man,
going
like this,
because
I work older
people. So you've met me, Dad. No, that's cheap.
No, I can't. I'm so bored, yes. Not for your
cause, my fault. Okay, we'll join it together. They'll be better than they get you. Oh, I don't do. I do my bit, because once a week I go around and I service the needs of my 93-year-old neighbour, ladies and gentlemen. That's listen, don't judge me, right? She may be 93, but she's got the vagina of a woman 10 years younger, right? It's fantastic. If you want to know what it's like, imagine, right, pumping a handful of mouldy biscuits, right? Or if you really want to push the boat out, right, licking out the sawdust through the bars of a hamster cage. You're ruining time in Chantel, but you're very pretty, I don't care. Who gives a shit? After. Oh, I'm going to enter with them. Anywho's thought for the day. Anywho's thought for the day, because a lot of people say to me, they say, Eddie, are you a lover? Or are you a fighter? And I reply, well, I like to think I'm a little bit of both. I'm a rapist. Oh dear, how long have I got to? Because I'm going to fuck off. Right, just do two, I'll do two. Rape, eh? Ooh, bit controversial. Joe Rick Santorum, who ran for Republican candidate, he said that he thought that he's a strict Catholic. He said that a child, anti-abortion, he said a child conceived through rape was the gift of life. And do you know what I thought? Joe, that must save a lot of money on Christmas presents. No, because it's about rape. Right. Has that just killed it?
Yeah.
Has it? Has it gone too far?
Sorry.
Really? Spoiled all the good work by doing that. I'll tell you the worst death I ever had at a club in Scotland. I did a rape joke, right? And this is true, this is absolutely true. The worst joke I ever did was in Scotland. I did this rape joke, I won't say what it was, and the room went silent. This woman went, No, you can't say that. You can't say that. There's nothing funny about rape. And do you know when you've got to say the first thing that comes into your head? Right, and unfortunately in my case was, oh, well, maybe not raping you. Out the back door. I'm going to end now. I'm going to end. People think that's nasty. Too nasty to say things like that. Is all it is? Too nasty? Do you know what? I think the world's nasty. I think people saying nasty things in real life. I don't tell many true stories because people go, you know, not going to say I fucking identify with that, are they? So this is true. Years ago, I used to work in a bakery in Bolton, right? I did. Anyone from Bolton? Someone's from Bolton here, aren't they tonight? No, I used to. not admitting, I used to work in a bakery in Bolton, and I used to work in cake decorating, and the woman in charge, she was about that high, she was about like 23 stone, right, and she was called Deborah, right? Now, being from Bolton, being imaginative, they used to call her Fat Debs, right? No, that's not nice, is it?
No.
It's not nice, is it? Now, that's horrible, but normally that would be horrible. She was the nastiest fucking bitch. She was the nastiest bitch you've ever met, right? She used to lean, this 23 stone woman, she used to lean on this metal table with wheels on it, metal table, and she used to lean there, and there'd be like these like 4 litre tubs of jam, raspberry jam. She'd stick her hands in it, eating it like that, right? Eating it. And she'd scream at all the girls to work hard. She's the nastiest bitch, right? So anyway, one night she was standing there on the night shift, all these girls working, right? And she was there, this big leaning on this table, big 4 litre tub of raspberry jam, right? Eating out of it, right? And she leaned a little bit too much, on the table, right? With the words, and it moved. And this little woman, this 23 stone woman, she fell back, right? On her back, and this tub of raspberry jam went up in the air, right down on top of her, right? And there was silence, right? And then suddenly this voice from the back went, oh, look everybody! Fat Debs has just had a miscarriage! Wasn't me! It was some anonymous person in Bolton. They're evil. Say again.
It was evil but funny.
Evil but funny, you said, anyway.
Why am I a
commentary
person?
Say again, before I go, go on.
Nahana was in.
Everyone's enjoying it so much. Really. Anyway, listen, I've enjoyed myself. Keep coming, and if you're lucky, you can beat Dave up afterwards and piss on his corpse. So, if you're lucky, I'll join you. You've got a really good headline to follow. My name is Eddie Hugh. Good night.